Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss about robot anatomy. Before I start with the robot anatomy, we should know what do you mean by robotics. Robotics is a branch of technology that deals with the concepts, design, construction, operations, and application of robots. Robot is nothing but a machine designed to execute one or more tasks repeatedly with speed and precision. Or you can put in other words, like machine, it is a machine that resembles a human and does mechanical routine tasks on command. As per the command, the robot is going to perform the operation. Why robot is required when a human can perform the task? Why we are going to use robot instead of human? Now you are seeing in developed countries, the robots are replacing human beings. Why it is done? Because it can work in hazardous environment. Like it will work in a nuclear reactor where it is not possible for human being to work there. It will be working in line of control, that is behind enemy lines. It will be used in military applications to observe the movements of the enemies in the line of control. The other reasons are because of its consistent work with repeatability and accuracy. And robot can be reprogrammed. And the other important point is the parts can be replaced when damaged. If the parts are damaged, you can replace. Whereas in human being, you can replace the part, but efficiency will not be there. For example, if a person loses its hand, you can replace the hand, but the efficiency will not be there. That's why the industries are looking for robot instead of human being. Now we will see the anatomy. This on the screen, whatever you are seeing, it is a robot anatomy. Robot anatomy deals with the study of different joints and links and other aspects of manipulator. A manipulator is nothing but it is an arm-like mechanism. It is similar to the human arm, which is designed to move materials, parts or tools without direct human contact. By using the manipulator, you can move the materials, parts or the tools without human assistance, or human will not be in direct contact. The parts of the robot anatomy, first one is a joint. Here in this you are seeing two joints, joint 1 and joint 2. Joint is nothing but it is the one that integrates two or more links. These are the links. Joint is nothing but which is going to integrate two or more links to provide controlled relative movement between input link and output link. For example, if you consider this as a joint, this will be input link and this will be output link. What do you mean by link? The link is a rigid member that connects the joint. Here you can see that two links, how you are going to connect? By using a joint. The links can be input and output link. And at the end of this, you will see the end effector. End effector is nothing but it will be like a hand. It is a device at the end of the robotic arm which is shaped like a hand or as a special tool depending upon the application. Depending upon the application, you can use different end effector. And you are seeing the base. Base is going to support the entire robot arm. This is about the robot anatomy. And in this anatomy, as we have different links and joints. Now we are going to study about the types of joints. On the screen you are seeing different types of joints. We will discuss one by one. The first one is the linear joint. In linear joint you have input link and output link. In linear joint, the relative movement between the input and output link is linear sliding motion. Here you can see the linear sliding motion with the axis of two links, that is input link and output link, being parallel. You can see the input and output links are parallel, and it is also called as L joint. Second one is a orthogonal joint. This is also a linear sliding motion, but the input link and the output link are perpendicular. Here you can see that the input link is perpendicular to the output link. This is also called as O joint. The third one is a rotational joint. In this type, it is going to provide a rotational relative motion of the joint with the axis of rotation perpendicular to the axis of input and output links. Here you can see that it is going to provide the rotational relative motion to both input and output, but it will be perpendicular. Whatever the rotation is there, it will be perpendicular to input as well as output link. This type of links are called as these types of joints are called as R joint. The next one is a twisting joint. This joint involves a rotary motion. Here you can see a rotary motion, but the axis of the rotation, is parallel to the axis of two links. Here you are seeing two links, input link and output link. The rotation motion of the axis, or the axis of rotation, is parallel to the axis of both the links, input as well as output link. These types of joints are called as T joint. The last one is revolving joint. The axis of the input link is parallel to the axis of rotation of the joint. Here the rotational motion is there. In this, the axis of the input link is parallel to the axis of rotation of the joint, and the axis of the output link, is perpendicular to the axis of rotation. Here the output link is perpendicular to the axis of rotation. This type of joints are called as V joint. Now we will see the applications of industrial robots, where you are going to use industrial robot. The application of the robots are grouped into three categories. The first category is material handling application. Material handling application, it includes material transfer and machine loading and unloading. Here we are going to use robot for material transfer as well as machine loading and unloading operations. What do you mean by material transfer application? Robots are used to move material or work parts from one location to another, usually referred as pick and place operation. Material transfer means here we are going to pick the material and we are going to place it to a certain location or for certain operation. Second one is machine loading and unloading operation. In machine loading and unloading operation, robot is used to load and unload the parts at the production. For the production purpose, you need to load the material and unload the material. There you can use the robot. The next one is for the processing application. In the processing application, it is used to perform a process on a work part. You need to do a process on a work part. For example, you can take a lathe. In that lathe, different processes are done. Similarly, here we are going to take the work part. For example, you can use for welding purpose, for grinding, for dip coating or spray painting, as I explained about the lathe. Like this, n number of processing applications are there where you can use. The one more is, a robot is programmed to hold and manipulate a tool to perform the desired operation. In this, you can program the robot to perform the desired operation. The last one is assembly and inspection. In the assembly and inspection, you can use the robot. Robots are used to assemble the various components of a product. It is used to assemble different products. For example, pick a part and inserting into another part with precise placement and orientation. Precise placement and orientation is important for the assembly purpose. Okay, once the assembly is done, then the inspection will be done. Inspection, where the robot positions a sensor with respect to the working part and determines whether a part is consistent with quality specifications. We'll be having the quality specifications. It is going to check whether the part is having that quality specification. If it is having a quality specification, then the product will be passed, otherwise it will be rejected. These are the applications. Now we'll see what are the advantages of using robots. It has some advantages as well as disadvantages. The advantages are, a robot can perform operations with precision and repeatability. This is important. Precision and repeatability every time. This level of consistency can be hard to achieve in human labor. That's why we are going for robot. Precision and repeatability is required in industry, whereas it is difficult to achieve with human labors. Robots have the ability to work continuously at constant speed without pausing for break. Using the robot, you can work for 24/7, whereas it is not possible using human labor. Robot increase workplace safety. They work under harsh and hazardous environment. Okay, in the workplace, safety is important. Okay, if you use a robot, then the workplace will be having a safer environment. Whereas, because of the human error, accidents might be there. And they work under harsh and hazardous environment. Like as I told you, in the nuclear reactor or other chemical industry where the environment is not suitable for human labors. Next is, robot reduces production cost, time and material waste, thereby helping in financial saving. This is important. This is for the economy or the financial assistance of or savings in the industry. Production cost, time and material waste need to be minimum. Then there will be a profit for the organization or the company. Robots can be programmed to perform variety of tasks. Giving n number of programs, you can perform variety of tasks using robot. Similarly, as we have discussed about the advantages, there are some limitations for robot. The limitations are, high initial investment. Initially, the investment will be high and also requires regular maintenance, resulting in increased cost. You need to have a proper maintenance. Otherwise, there will be a failure of components or the parts of a robot. Robots are incapable of performing tasks outside of their predefined program. As we have discussed in the advantage, you are going to give the program to the robot. Okay, it is going to perform whatever the instructions you have given. Okay, it will not perform other than which is required. Whereas they cannot handle the unexpected as human labors are capable of doing. Human labors are going to solve the unexpected problems, whereas robots are going to perform what is programmed. Robots require considerable human interventions to perform some complex tasks. It is difficult to perform the complex task only by the help of a robots. In some of the cases, human intervention is needed. The last one is important. Use of robots can lead to increase in unemployment. In all the sectors you are seeing, the robots are replacing human beings. Even in hotels also, the service which is given by human, now it has been replaced by robots. Means it will result into unemployment. Thank you for watching the video.